He's also mentioned in Rig Ved, book number 1, chapter number 53, verse number 9. He is mentioned as Ahmad, which means one who praises in Uttarchik, mantra number 1500. It's mentioned in Indra, chapter number 2, verse number 152. Yajurved, chapter number 31, verse number 18. He is also mentioned in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 126, verse number 1 to 14. He is called as Narashansa. Nar means man, person. Shansa means coming from Prashansa, praiseworthy. A man who's praiseworthy. If you translate Narashansa, man who's praiseworthy, into Arabic, it means Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He's prophesied as Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in Rig Ved, book number 1, hymn number 13, verse number 3. In Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 64, verse number 3. He's mentioned Rig Ved, book number 2, hymn number 3, verse number 5. Rig Ved, book number 5, hymn number 5, verse number 2. He's also mentioned Yajurved, chapter number 20, verse 37. Yajurved, chapter number 21, verse number 31. I can go on and on and on, mentioning only the references of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned in Hindu scriptures. Due to limitation of time, I will just touch on one prophecy a little bit in more detail. He's been prophesied as the Kalki Avatar. You know, when you read the Kalki Purana, book number 2, verse number 5, 7, 9, 11, 14, he's prophesied as the Kalki Avatar. And it's mentioned there that his father's name will be Vishnu Yas. Vishnu means God, Yas means servant, servant of God. If you translate to Arabic, it's Abdullah. The father of the name of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was Abdullah. His mother's name will be Sumati. Sumati means serenity, peaceful. If you translate in Arabic, it means Amina. The name of the mother of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is Amina. It says he will be born in a city by the name Sambala. Sambala means a place of peace and serenity. That is Makkah. He'll be born in the house of the chief of the village of Sambala. He was born in the house of Quraysh.